Today, Robert Levinson's family urged the U.S. government to do more to bring him home. The retired FBI agent vanished in Iran in 2007, and yesterday we learned that he'd been working for the CIA. Senior correspondent John Miller was an assistant director of the FBI at the time of Levinson's disappearance. John, what can you tell us now?
Well, Scott, for 7 years, Robert Levinson's family kept a secret that he was operating under contract for the CIA, gathering information and reports on various countries, including Iran. These revelations may dramatically change the dynamics of negotiations for his return.
There are no words to describe the nightmare. My family and I have been living every day.
Christine Levinson has been pleading for information on the fate of her husband since he disappeared. It was 2007 when Levinson flew to the Iranian island of Kish in the Persian Gulf. Later, we are told, he was sent to a prison and then a hospital in Tehran. By 2010, reports had Levinson somewhere near the Pakistani border. The U.S. government's search for Levinson has since grown cold. Iran has, at times, seemed to know about Levinson. Last year, Charlie Rose of CBS This Morning put the matter to then-president of Iran, Mahmoud Ahmadinejad.
I remember that last year, Iranian and American intelligence groups had a meeting, but I haven't followed up on it. I thought they had come to some kind of an agreement.
But this year, the new president of Iran, Hassan Rouhani, seemed to deny knowing about Levinson's fate.
We do not know any information, have any information about this person. Actually, our intelligence services have said that he is not in Iran.
Today, in Tel Aviv, Secretary of State John Kerry declined comment on whether Levinson was working for the CIA in Iran, but pledged to continue seeking his return.
I personally raised it with the Iranians in the course of our discussions, and we will continue to try to seek his release and return to the United States.
Late today, David McGee, an attorney for the Levinson family, said the U.S. government needs to do more.
They have not worked to full capacity. They have not made his case a priority case. He has always been second fiddle to some other issue with Iran. And it's been 6.5 years. It's time for him to be at the top of the pile.
John, what kind of information was Levinson looking for in Iran?
Well, we don't know exactly, but I'll tell you, Robert Levinson was an expert at two things. One, interview skills, getting people to talk. The other thing was on money laundering and hiding of assets. So when you have a country where he had a source to interview and where they're under sanctions, those could be two key skills.
Now, we've just learned that when he went missing several years ago, three analysts at the CIA were fired in the case. Why was that?
Robert Levinson was under a contract for the analysis division. What they do is they run experts who can give them expert opinions that will help in analysis. What the operations division does is they run agents in the field. And the reason they were fired is they found the analysts were running Robert Levinson not as an expert, but as an agent in the field, which they weren't qualified or allowed to do.
Thanks, John.